Your Honor, will you please swear the witness?
Yes. If you would remain standing and raise your right hand, please. Do you swear or affirm that any statements or testimony you give will be the truth, nothing but the truth, under the pains and penalties of perjury?
I do.
Please be seated.
Good afternoon, Ms. Berry.
Good afternoon.
Could you state your name and spell it for the record, please?
Lauren Berry, LauRenBarry.
Ms. Berry, what do you do for work?
I work as a firefighter and advanced EMT.
Can you describe your training for that position?
You go through a rigorous program of learning how to perform life-saving skills on humans, I guess.
Okay.
I don't really have a specific way to... I went through training.
Well, where did you go through that training?
The New Hampshire Fire Academy, as well as New England EMS Institute.
And how long ago was that?
As far as my license I'm currently at was 2015.
Okay, and did you have one before that?
I did.
And what was that?
EMT.
When did you go through that?
I don't remember the exact year.
Okay.
I was 19. I'm 34 now.
Okay. Were you working at AMR on December 25th of 2022?
I was.
What was your role at AMR at that
time? Advanced EMT.
Okay. And so what's the difference between an EMT and an advanced EMT?
EMT is what they call BLS. It's the lowest license level of an EMT. Advanced EMT is in between a paramedic and an EMT. So it's ALS, but not quite a paramedic.
Okay, so you're in between an EMT and a paramedic?
Correct.
And so on December 25th of 2022, were you on duty?
I was.
And were you in an ambulance?
I was.
Did you get called to an emergency at 12:30 a.m.?
I did.
Where was the emergency located?
The west side of Manchester, 3 Electric Street.
Can you describe the location where you first arrived at 3 Electric Street?
So we arrived to the same location as Manchester Fire's Truck 6, which was at the crossing of Electric Street and the rail trail by the trestle bridge.
So Truck 6 was already there?
Correct.
Okay. Was there any other emergency vehicles there?
Not at that time, no.
No police cars?
They had been requested, but they hadn't arrived yet.
Okay. So was... So how did you get dispatched?
I would assume through the 911 system. AMR is dispatched through Manchester Fire, which they receive their calls from the 911 from the state.
Okay, so the 911 system contacts the fire department, is that right?
Sometimes it goes through the police department first or the fire department, but they communicate with each other, and then they dispatch the appropriate apparatus for the type of call that's being requested.
Okay, so it sounds like in this instance, it went through the fire department, and then the fire department dispatched the ambulance?
Yes, right? Simultaneously with fire and EMS, or at the same time.
I just want to get you up here to point some things out on this. This map, if you would. Remove this microphone, please. All right, can you, will you put a number, the number one, where you first arrived at the scene? And you describe that as the intersection of the rail trail and?
Electric Street.
Electric Street, okay. And before we get too far, could you mark the northwest corner of this map?
Sure.
With just an NW?
You have another trick?
Yes, I do. Her name is Eva. Thank you.
expecting to replace the one.
Please do. And then place a SE in the southwest corner. And what's that line that runs from where you put the SE to the, where you put the NW?
That would be the rail trail.
So who was at the scene when you arrived?
MFD personnel of truck 6, as well as myself and my female partner, Natalia Risher.
Okay. Anyone else there?
The patient.
Okay.
As well as, at that time, a male I didn't know.
Okay. Do you see that patient in the room today?
Yes.
Could you just point out an article of clothing she's wearing?
White coat.
Okay. And where is she sitting?
At the defendant's table.
Your Honor, I'd ask the record reflect that the witness identified the defendant.
The record shall so reflect.
Did you have a conversation with that woman?
I did, yes.
What'd she tell you?
She informed me that she had what she believed delivered 2 babies in the woods.
Where did she say she was when she gave birth?
She had a very descriptive story that she was coming from a store on the from the east side of the city, because it was Christmas night, it was the only one open. So she was heading back from that direction when she felt the urge to have a bowel movement. So she walked roughly 1 to 2 minutes into the woods and found out she had delivered a baby.
Okay, so is she? So she's coming from the area that you marked SE?
Yes.
So where were you when this conversation took place?
We were still positioned at number 1. I was in the back of the ambulance with her.
Was there anyone else in the back of the ambulance?
Intermittently at times, my partner, as well as one of the staff from Manchester Fire for a brief moment.
Okay, so it's you.
It was just me.
So it's you, your partner, and somebody intermittently from Manchester Fire?
Correct.
At that time, you said you were in the back of the ambulance?
Yes.
Was the ambulance closed? Were the doors closed?
Yes. After the patient was loaded, yes.
Okay. And when you say the patient was loaded, what do you mean by that?
We had assisted her off the ground due to her condition, placed her on a stretcher, secured her, and placed her in the back of the ambulance to start treatment.
Okay. Was she laying down when you arrived or something else?
She was seated on the ground, semi-Fowler, so sort of at a sitting upright position.
Okay, so she was sitting on the ground when you arrived, and then you put her on a stretcher, you said?
Correct.
And then you put that stretcher in the ambulance?
Correct.
Okay. What was the temperature like in the ambulance?
I would say, I don't have an exact, but it was warm enough that I didn't need a coat in my ambulance.
Okay.
It was warm.
Was there any threat to anyone's safety inside the ambulance there?
No.
Okay. And you said the doors were closed?
Correct.
The heat was on?
Correct.
Okay, and this, just so we're clear, this is the first time that you're in the ambulance with the defendant. Is that correct?
Correct, yep.
About how long were you in the ambulance that first time with the defendant?
I would have to estimate, but it had to be enough that I got an initial assessment. We repositioned the ambulance and then made the decision to further. So probably upwards of 10 minutes.
Okay.
A little bit longer.
So 10 minutes or so, and what does an initial assessment consist of?
It's a rapid triage. You essentially try to look over your patient, see what is life-threatening, and try to correct those life-threatening medical emergencies.
Okay. So did you do that with Ms. Eckersley?
Yes.
Okay. What did you find?
She had what appeared to be delivered a baby. I believed in my experience of having mothers, they usually think the placenta is a second baby, so the initial instinct was to look for the cord, which was not there. I had then updated Manchester Fire that they were looking for 1 baby and not 2.
Okay. Did you provide medical assistance?
I did, yep. We did fundus massaging, initial set of vitals, asked some medical questions.
Did you offer to take her to the hospital?
I did, yes.
What was your response?
She didn't want to go. She declined.
So when people decline to go to the hospital and they have a medical issue, what do?
So in the protocols of our state, it's called an against medical advice, AMA. So I explained to her, I make sure that she's cognitive enough to make decisions and is able to make that decision, in which case she was.
What does that mean, cognitive enough?
She was in the right state of mind to be able to make a clear decision for herself.
Well, how do you do that?
Certain questions. Does she know who she is, where she is, what's going on, what the date is a simple one. Simple questions that you'd be able to answer if you were in the state of mind to be able to make a decision of not going to the hospital.
Does she have any trouble answering any of those questions?
No, sir.
Okay, so what do you do if somebody's in the right state of mind and they refuse medical treatment?
I have to honor those wishes. I can't kidnap her. I can't assault her and forcibly bring her. All I can do is educate, which case I did. Informed her that it was a life-threatening situation, that she could potentially have the bleeding start again. That was strongly advised that she go to the hospital and seek treatment after the birth.
Okay, so it sounds like the bleeding stopped then?
At that point, yes, it has slowed.
Okay, and you were concerned that it may have restarted, it may restart again?
Yes.
And that's why you wanted to transport her to the hospital?
For multiple reasons, but that being one of them, yes.
Okay, so after she refused medical treatment, what did you do then?
We asked her to assist in finding the location of the baby, being that she would be the best source for that.
Okay. And did she agree to do that?
She did.
And where did you guys go from there?
At that point, the ambulance was positioned behind the ice arena, further down on Electric Street. So we exited the ambulance and began
searching. you guys were already, at this point during the conversation, you're already behind the ice arena?
Correct. My partner had repositioned the ambulance to a staging location with truck 6 behind the ice arena.
Okay. So as I understand it, you were inside the ambulance at position 1 there.
Correct.
And then while you're still in the back of the ambulance with the defendant, your partner drove you down behind the ice arena?
Correct.
Okay. And where did you stop behind the ice arena?
There's a parking lot behind the ice arena that abuts the baseball fields.
Can you put a number 2 there and circle that too?
Sure. Sorry, it's blurry.
You never know what's going to happen with that screen.
User error.
Okay. So now you're down behind the ice arena. You're in the ambulance. What made you go down behind the ice arena?
Through the chaos of trying to coordinate with the Manchester Fire personnel of searching and having a plan in place, as well as her being unsure of wanting to go to the hospital, I assume best thought by my partner to keep everybody in the same location, and that was the area that she'd originally directed us to, so it felt appropriate in the time.
Okay, so the defendant directed you to the area behind the ice arena?
Yes, she had stated that she was coming back from a store from the east side of the city when she was walking on the trail. At one point, she had mentioned the soccer fields.
So about how long were you in the staging area there before, I assume you left the ambulance at some point?
Briefly, a few moments. Okay. I don't have an exact.
Okay. And the defendant agreed to show you where the baby was?
Your Honor. Yes. Objection. Leading. Sustained.
Did the defendant agree to show you where the baby was?
Yes. She was willing.
So what did you do then?
At that time, Manchester PD had arrived. So myself, my partner, and a Manchester police officer walked with Miss Eckersley around, with her leading around the baseball fields. There's fields down there, and there's a path that's just people have walked over. She proceeded to look around and follow this path around the field and then across and up a slight incline to the rail trail.
Okay, so in that initial, did she say that the baby was there?
No, she was searching for something that looked familiar.
Okay. And so her initial search area was around the ball fields or the soccer fields?
So the ball fields are here and the soccer fields are here. So we were positioned here, cut around the ball fields, and then up onto the rail trail. Truck 6 was at the soccer fields at that time searching.
Okay. So can you put a number 3 at the soccer fields? And put a circle around that?
Trying to not have it affect the...
How long were you at the soccer fields?
Again, I don't have an exact time, but it was enough that I personally went out and searched an area by myself. Truck 6 had called in more resources for Engine 6 to come. They thoroughly searched with a TIC, which is a thermal imaging camera, for body temperatures. So it was a decent amount of time.
Did the defendant say that the baby was in a tent in the soccer fields?
At no point in time was a tent mentioned, no.
All right. Did she say that it was near a tree in the soccer fields?
No, just a wooded area.
Did you find a baby in the soccer fields?
No.
Did you find any indication that a baby had ever been in the soccer fields?
No.
Are you aware of where the baby was while you were with the defendant searching the soccer fields?
I was not.
About how long were you searching the soccer fields? I'm sorry, you might have already answered that.
I didn't have an exact time. I wasn't really paying attention to the time while I was out there. A decent amount of time.
What was the defendant doing while you were...
She was standing on the rail trail with officers and my paramedic partner.
What happened after you searched the soccer fields?
I had come back to where they were all standing and noticed that Miss Eckersley was bleeding again, and advised that we should probably go back to the ambulance because her condition had changed.
Okay. So you went back to the ambulance?
Correct.
So it sounds like this is your second trip to the ambulance, is that correct?
Correct.
All right. And what was the ambulance in the same place?
It was, yep.
In that little staging area there?
Yes.
Okay. So you went back, you got in the ambulance, right?
Yes.
Okay. Were all of the doors closed on the ambulance?
Yes. At times, people were opening them. I don't recall who, but for the most part, yes, while we evaluated her.
Who else was in the ambulance with you?
I believe it was Officer Collins and my partner at times.
Still warm, comfortable, secure inside the ambulance?
Yes.
Were you continuing to offer medical care to the defendant?
Yes.
And what was her response to that?
Still did not want any medical care. She didn't want to be transported. I don't.
Okay. So you said there was an officer in the ambulance with you?
Correct.
Was your partner in the ambulance with you?
I believe at times. I don't recall the exact how or long or for where. I know there was people that were opening the door constantly to mention things or conversate with others, but.
Okay. So this time in the ambulance, was this any different from the last time in the ambulance? As far as the environment?
There was an officer in the back, okay. As opposed to prior there wasn't.
Okay. Okay, so do you video or audio record the events in the back of an ambulance?
Not commonly. It's HIPAA. If something, if there's an active investigation, officers have body cams, but EMS does not, no.
Okay, so for the first time that you were in the ambulance, between the point where you first met the defendant and the number two there in the staging area, you didn't video or audio record any of that, right?
No, sir.
And there wasn't any police officer in there, right?
Not at that time, no.
Okay, but it sounds like the second time there was a police officer there.
Yes.
And were you aware of whether he was recording?
I just always assumed. Manchester PD commonly has body cameras on.
Okay. Okay, so I'm going to show you a video clip from your interactions with the defendant that second time in the ambulance.
Can I approach?
Yes.
Attorney Sweeney, should we let her be seated? Or do you want her standing? Oh, if she's, that's fine.
I'm okay with standing, honestly. Thank you.
Did you have an opportunity to look at a video from a body-worn camera?
Yes.
Okay. And what was that video of?
There was two, I believe, that I witnessed. One was in the back of the ambulance.
Okay, so for that one in the back of the ambulance, was that a fair and accurate representation of what occurred that night?
Yes.
Do you know who was taking that video?
Officer Collins.
Okay, were you in that video?
Yes.
Did you see all the things that happened in that video?
Yes.
Did you hear all the things that happened in that video?
Yes. Of the Claire statements, yes.
Okay, so I'm going to show that video now. This is Exhibit 1. It's a full exhibit, Your Honor.
Okay.
Thank you. Sure, let's sir, can we put lights
Greg,
down a little bit?
Can we put the lights up there?
Thank you.
Are you sure that you didn't come from over? Yeah, I was talking to myself as well.
Can I be the door?
You can hang there if you want.
Okay, and or just roll it a little bit.
She's bleeding heavily, so I'm trying to get low.
Okay, do you see yourself in this video?
I did, yes.
And where are you standing?
What they call the CPR seat, to the right of the screen. I'm off the screen. My partner's directly in front.
Just confirm it wasn't the homeless camp by the bridge.
Were you?
By the bridge?
So
she was, that's where she lives. That's where she lives.
So she was
that's what makes sense. Up over here?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's where she lives.
So she was coming from the store, from the east side.
Yeah.
Hadn't made it to there yet.
So you're telling, it looks like you're telling a firefighter where she was coming from?
Lieutenant Pullen, yes.
Where did you get that information?
From the patient, I call her patient, the defendant. I apologize.
So you're telling, so you're relaying that information to Lieutenant Pullen?
Yes, he was looking to do a further search and was asking what would be the best way to go about that. So we were trying to make a plan.
And he asked you about the encampment?
Yes, Manchester Fire has a squad detail. They frequently visit all of the encampments, so he's well knowledgeable in the local encampments of that were under that area. So he was asking because in his gut he thought that that might be a location.
Okay, and had the defendant said anything about that encampment up to that point?
No, not in my presence that I was aware of. I do know that she hadn't made it home yet, so to me that was didn't make sense at that time.
What do you mean it didn't make sense?
I was going off of what she said for the story, so I didn't think searching her home made sense because she said she didn't make it home yet.
Did she say she didn't have the baby at home?
She had stated 1 to 2 minutes into the woods off the trail on her way home.
She was, when you found her, she lives on the golf side of the bridge. Her brother's tent is on this side,
right,
close to where we are.
Yeah.
That's why the boyfriend went that way. East on the rail trail when we saw her.
Her tent, coming from Goffstown side?
No, she was coming from downtown,
yeah,
from the store to come back to her tent, which is on the Goffstown west side of that bridge.
I see. So why was she down here? Why were you down here, hon, on this side?
She's going back to the tent from the...
Okay, can you tell me what she said?
Can you replay it? I'm sorry.
Well, females having babies,
it's just freezing. Her brother. She's bleeding heavily, so I'm trying to get blood
pressure. Can we just confirm it wasn't the homeless camp by the bridge?
Where are
you? By the bridge?
So
she was, that's where she lives. That's where she lives.
So
that's
she
what she's
coming?
That's what makes sense.
Up over here?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's where she lives.
So she was coming from the store, from the east side,
yeah,
hadn't made it to there yet. She was, when you found her, she lives on the golf side, mm-hmm, of that bridge. Her brother's tent is on this side,
right,
close to where we are.
Yeah.
That's why the boyfriend went that way, east, on the rail trail when we saw him.
Her tent. Coming from Goffstown side?
No, she was coming from downtown,
yeah,
from the store to come back to her tent, which is on the Goffstown west side of that bridge.
I see. So why was she down here? Why were you down here, hon, on this side?
She's going back to the tent from the store. 7-Eleven. I don't move at 7 ways to Sunday.
So you're just relaying information from her? Is that what you're doing there?
That was the primary conversation that I had at initial location one, when it was just me and her, and that's where those details came from. I was asking her because it was abnormal to me that a male was just leaving her. So I said, where is he going? That was when she informed me that he was going to find her brother on that side of the rail trail to inform him that she was had the baby or had a baby.
Okay, but in this video, she's laying next to you saying things. Are you repeating what she said or talking over her or something else?
I was relaying information that I didn't need to talk over, so I guess I talked over her, but I was relaying information that I had prior collected from the defendant.
I'll make it clear to me.
Saying there?
Not from this distance of the TV, I apologize.
But you don't remember what she was telling you?
Not at that moment, no. Currently, no.
Called your boyfriend? She's silent.
What's his phone number?
Alexandra.
I would be calling him on Messenger. There's a tablet.
Yeah.
At this point, she's talking about calling her boyfriend?
On Messenger app, Wi-Fi calling. You can call through Wi-Fi.
911 only.
Like a...
Can you call him off of Messenger, please? We need to know where this baby is at. Yes, please.
Where's your phone?
It's, no Curtis. If I could use a hotspot.
You don't have Wi-Fi, that's still?
Why not?
So at this point in time, is she trying to get a phone so she can call her boyfriend?
I believe she's looking for her phone.
Okay.
She had her phone on her person throughout the time.
What was she, why was she wanting a phone?
At this point was to contact the boyfriend via Messenger, so that's where they're asking, but she had had her phone with her throughout.
Don't have any minutes on it?
Yeah,
we're
on the way.
I just want to understand, so you're in an ambulance, the doors are closed, the police officer's in there, it's a perfectly secure environment, right?
Correct.
And now she wants to call her
Objection,
boyfriend?
Bleeding. Sustained.
What did she want to do?
Contact her boyfriend.
What's your boyfriend's name again?
George. It should be on now. You can
look. And is that your hand operating the phone?
Correct.
And is that her phone or your?
I'm pretty sure that was my phone. I was trying to assist her in getting in contact with him, which I never successfully did.
Did she give you a phone number for her boyfriend?
I believe that was what she was trying to do in that moment, was give me some sort of contact information.
So it looks like everyone in the ambulance is trying to get a hold of the defendant's boyfriend, is that right?
Correct.
What for?
In hopes he could help us find the baby, because he was also there at the birth.
Okay.
She was requesting that we contact him, so we try to assist helping.
She was trying to get her boyfriend to come back to the ambulance?
I would assume that's why she wanted to call him, to come back to where she was. I can't speculate that.
Or, I believe you.
Sure.
Does George have any like scars on his face or tattoos on his face? How long have you guys been dating? Did you guys used to date like before though?
No.
Yeah. Have you guys ever gotten arrested together?
No.
You're on our food perch.
Yes.
Yes.
Is it working?
actually lived in the bedroom and I've got to. Do you see my phone about the radio?
Yes.
Are you guys still trying to find a phone to call her boyfriend?
Yes.
Oh my god.
They couldn't just start blowing out. They did. Yeah. No, it's dry. Well, I actually,
the same questions you asked her when you were in the ambulance the first time?
Yes, similar, yes.
Similar?
Yep.
Alexandra, what's your last name? What's your last name?
Eckersley, like you called him that.
Eckersley, spell it.
E-C-K-E-R-S-L-E-Y.
Save it.
So it looks like everyone left the ambulance at this point. Are you still in there?
I had just stepped out. Manchester PD was trying to gain access to a gate with a Halligan, and I assisted them. They were trying to get a cruiser up onto the rail trail to put better lighting for the search.
Okay, so, you had some sort of key or something?
No, I radioed to the officers that have the key, in which case they gave me permission to use their tools on their engine, being that I'm trained for that, to open the gate.
Okay, so at this point, there's no one else in the ambulance but the officer?
Just the officer and her, as
to my knowledge. Guys ever get a hold of the boyfriend?
No.
Did you give up on that?
I was still trying to make the baby a priority.
Okay. Wasn't getting a hold of the boyfriend part of the finding the baby?
Yes.
But you were no longer trying to get a hold of the boyfriend now?
No, we had stepped out to call our supervisor, in which case you hear me say, why do you have a Halligan? Because the cops are trying to take a gate out with a Halligan.
Okay. Was anyone else trying to get a hold of the boyfriend to get him to the scene?
I'm not sure. I can't speak for everyone else on
the
scene. But
did you see anyone else trying to get a hold of the boyfriend to get him to the scene?
No, I did not.
Okay.
Do you receive mail anywhere? Because you're not from here. Yeah, it's hard to keep track of, I get it. You couldn't call him off the phone?
This tablet that has somebody that's time on it is actually currently done. It's just so bad. No one is able to attack him. Not on the phone.
Alex, what'd you get from the store earlier?
I grabbed some cigarettes for last night.
Where are the cigarettes?
In there.
Do you have a receipt by any chance?
No, I never get a receipt. I've on my phone.
Yeah.
Well,
do you know what street the store is on?
No, I'm trying to navigate the address.
Do you know anything that's like around the store?
Honestly, I still try to navigate Manchester, like I said.
I gotcha.
Any more than you for boyfriend?
Did you hear that, Alexandra?
What?
What's your boyfriend's name?
Yeah, George what?
Burge
is what he goes by, but his last name
is Burge. Burge? How do you spell that?
B-U-R-G-E.
What makes you say that? That sounds real last name.
He has IDs.
What's his ID say?
I don't remember, but it was not as Burge is pretty long, and the last letter is that I think it was like 10 letters total. 10 or 11.
Alright. And can you just describe him for me one time?
White, cocky, brown color.
Yeah.
About 5'8", 5'9", like she, the lady already said as well.
White, brown, curly hair. Alpha, Lima, Echo, X-ray, Alpha, November, Delta, Romeo, India, Alpha. Last name is Echo, Charlie, Kilo, Echo, Romeo, Sierra, Lima, Echo, Yankee, 12-4-96. One, as far as the other half of this, the male party goes, she said that he goes by the street name Burge. It's a white male with brown curly hair, probably in his mid-30s. Any facial hair?
No. How common is a situation like this? Not the part where the kid is not here. Not just the general scenario. Not knowing the pregnant.
Copy, thank you. There's a lot of people who go a long time pregnant, not knowing that they're pregnant.
Situation where they may have been maybe those 3 months off when it comes out.
I'm not a medical professional by any means, but the way that it's been explained to me by my fiance is that it's very common for women to lose children in the first trimester, because that's when you run into all the problems medically that sort of.
Being outdoors,
not being in like good, like medical physical condition. Exactly, and though all those things topple up, to my understanding, you're much better off asking the EMTs because they're more experienced in all this stuff and they have a better idea. Like 5 years.
My ex went to prison. Got caught for dealing drugs. Doing a lot of time now.
so that's how you see my ex. We're what have been going on to our sixth year, not meeting halfway through.
Who's that who just returned?
My paramedic partner that night, Natalia Rusher.
Things went sideways.
He was getting on himself, getting over his head.
I gotcha. It's not an easy life, being on the streets.
At least I can say this much about her. She was having been doing all cooking.
I gotcha.
Giselle from Disney.
What's up?
You know the movie Enchanted?
Yeah.
So before she woke up in New York, it was a cartoon?
Yeah.
That cartoon world was me.
Oh, it was?
Before her movie got to me, I was here 6 years ago. That's how, like, I didn't know anything about her life. I didn't.
Yeah. I gotcha.
I didn't have the grief process correctly. I had no life experience with something.
That's me.
Alexandra.
Yes.
Do you remember anything now that you're a little bit warmer?
I'm still with the chalk.
I know. And I know that you don't. I know that you don't want to talk about this right now, but we have to.
Like, I can always call you guys.
Sweetheart, that's not the way it works.
So here's the thing. Not to scare you, you're not in any sort of trouble. When you have a baby, no matter how far along that baby is, and it's now out of you, it's actually a life. We can't just forget it in the woods. I'm not saying
that's
the severity of
what you do. That's all we're trying to do.
I put it out over there. I thought Jeff had already checked her, but apparently not.
No.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm just trying to have you understand the severity of, like, you can't just forget it. Maybe, like, in a couple days we'll find it, like,
across the bridge.
Are you fucking kidding me right now?
I gotta fucking tell you.
So you were on the Goss Town side of the bridge with the baby?
Yeah.
Goss Town side of the bridge?
Yeah, I wanted to make sure that I didn't, like, tell that.
Okay. Is there anything else that you want to tell us before this becomes an actual...
So we're gonna come.
Hey, sorry.
I can't.
Right after she told you that the baby's on the Goss side of the bridge at the camp, what did she say after that?
Could you replay it again, please?
The severity of, like, you can't just forget it. Maybe, like, in a couple days we'll find it. Like,
across the bridge.
Are you fucking kidding me right now?
I'd rather fucking tell you.
So you were on the Goss Town side of the bridge with the baby?
Yeah.
Goss Town side of the bridge?
Yeah, I wanted to make sure that I didn't get yelled at.
Okay.
She wanted to make sure she didn't get yelled at.
Okay.
Is there anything else you want to tell us before this becomes an actual...
So we're going to come...
Hey,
sorry.
Yeah,
I can't... The
baby's out for cancer.
Do you remember what she was saying?
To the best of my knowledge, I don't remember exact wording, but if I stood still, I don't have the best hearing with sirens after years, so being over here is a little difficult.
I thought Jeff had already checked her, but apparently not.
No.
Yeah.
There's no severity of, like, you can't just forget it. Maybe, like, in a couple days we'll find it. Like,
if...
Are you fucking kidding me right now?
I'd rather fucking tell you.
So you were on the Goss Town side of the bridge with the baby?
Yeah.
Goss Town side of the bridge?
Yeah, I wanted to make sure that I didn't make all that.
Okay. Is there anything else that you want to tell us before this becomes an actual...
So we're going to come.
Hey,
sorry.
I can't.
The
baby's out for cancer.
She wanted to bring us there herself.
Well, thank you, Alexandra.
Yeah.
So...
It
looks
at her cancer.
Thank you.
Now that we're behind closed doors, what?
What is she telling you now?
What is she about to tell me? That she agrees that it's a life.
I don't mind doing it.
You did the right thing.
Do you know where your campsite is?
Sit there. I know exactly where it is. I didn't want to risk the alley and we're behind the doors, so I feel safe enough to tell you.
Okay, you're not...
What did she just say?
She wanted to make sure she was behind closed doors because she didn't feel safe enough to tell us.
She didn't feel safe enough to tell you?
Her words.
Okay.
He can't touch you, he can't do anything to you.
Why are you telling her that?
Reassuring her that George can't get to her or take...
That George can't get to her?
Yes.
Wait, didn't you just spend like 10, 15 minutes trying to get George to the scene?
Yes.
And now she's saying she feels secure because he's not there so she can tell everyone where the baby is?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay.
You did a good thing.
And it's a life, you're not a life.
Thank you.
I actually respect that, you know? It's not that far.
She said a minute and a half to 2 minute walk right there. There's a lieutenant firefighter who just headed over that way. Tan guy, he has an idea where the game is. I don't know what his name is.
Show us where the game is. I can do that.
Who is the firefighter who was just in here talking about that camp, the lieutenant?
Alexandra, let's go. Come show us where the
game is. Engine and truck six. So you go half the castle, it's like a 20 club.
Alexandra, you're rolling with us, sweetheart. Let's do it. Good job. Here, wrap yourself up. I don't want you cold.
You guys don't.
Okay, let's go. Let's go find the baby. We did it.
Let's do it.
Let's go. Show me the way, sweetheart. She's on a mission right now. We're good.
Did you call her?
Yes.
Do you actually know where we're going right now?
Yeah, let me take it back to the other side.
Right. Rubbing blood all over me and stuff.
Sorry.
I want to make sure you're not playing games, all right?
No, I'm sorry. I'm not.
All right, good, Alexandria. Making progress here.
You want to tell us about
all right, let's make this happen, right? Are you sure that he's not over here somewhere?
Where is she headed to?
The location of the baby.
I have it written down.
Did she ever slow down?
Something absurdly wrong with the K?
Eckersley. No.
Eckersley? You guys catch that?
At any point did she not look like she knew exactly where she was going?
I need you to pay attention. Was he over here at all? Were you over here? Do you recognize this area? Okay. We're all good.
You
got all your partners with him. We're here to take care of you, but we gotta find this. And it's cold, so you can go to the hospital.
Come on. Come on.
Are we clothes?
No, no clothes, no, but my husband.
Okay. Perhaps we go and grab the baby. You can go to the hospital, warm up. Make sure you're healthy.
Nope.
You don't want to go?
Nope. I don't have to. I don't have to.
Okay. It's up to you.
I have a heater.
You have a heater?
Yeah. Two full problems.
All right.
Can you tell where we are?
About to be on the trestle bridge in the northwest.
And where is that on the map?
Right back at position one.
Okay. Can you draw a line from the staging area to position one?
Sure.
Sorry. Your Honor, I guess the record reflects that the clock says 2:18 at this moment.
As long as you're hurrying. We're almost there. Watch, hey, stop, Alexandra. You see that cruiser?
I do, yes.
I want you to get hit. Go. Jeff, do not park your car right there. Move! You're blocking the whole street!
So is this where you met her, or did you meet her somewhere else?
Nope, next to the blue marking on the camera is where she was seated on the ground when I initially made patient contact.
Okay, so now you're back at the initial meeting location.
Correct.
Okay. And now it's 2:19.
Alexandra?
Yes.
Your boyfriend's over here?
No, he's back.
How are you making out, Alexandra? You're gonna bring me right to where we need to go. I need you to, because I don't know my way around.
I can tell you something. I want to see if I don't get off the
street. Yeah, keep your head on the swivel, buddy. Are these from your cigarettes? These wrappers
no.
Right here, Alexandria?
They're not from me, though.
Okay.
Hey, stick with her for 1 second, Vitaly. Hey, we got blood over here. Is this just the placenta?
So at this point, are you getting to the campsite?
I was in that grouping of flashlights just about to witness the placenta, but yes, we are almost at the campsite.
Time now is 2:22.
Your Honor, may we approach?
Yes. Right. Ladies and gentlemen, the parties just want me to clarify. I'm not taking judicial notice of any of the timing issues as relating to this clock, so I'll let the parties proceed. But to the extent you think that I am taking judicial notice or pointing out any evidence, you should ignore that belief. Thank you.
What time did, oh, you can have a seat now. Thank you.
Are you going to keep playing this? Or?
No. What time did you recover the baby?
I believe it was 1:40 a.m. was patient, quote unquote, contact.
Okay, and can you tell us again what time you arrived at the scene?
The initial dispatch was 12:30, believed to be 12:29 in some seconds, so 12:30. Okay. And then I believe our on-scene time was roughly 12:40 or 12:41.
Can you describe where the baby was when you recovered him?
He was on the floor of the makeshift tent.
What's the difference between a baby and a fetus?
A fetus is unhatched or unborn, so believed to be in the womb still, and a baby is that of human life.
We're searching for a baby or fetus?
Initially, in the beginning moments, it was believed to be, well, at all points it was going to be a baby, but whether a fetal demise or a baby that's viable versus non-viable. At no point was I searching for a fetus, because I would have had the fetus, then it would still be in her womb.
What you had in your arms as you're hustling away from the tent, what was that?
A baby, infant.
Okay. Can you describe what the baby looked like when you first encountered him?
He was unclothed, naked, without blankets, cyanotic, or blue for more layman's terms, ineffectively breathing, but breathing, and minimal chest rise, cold to the touch. The birth matter hadn't been disturbed on the baby to indicate that it had been touched at all. It was almost crystallized, and he was like cold like cement. He had an umbilical cord that was severed and not clamped.
What did you do when you picked him up?
I wrapped him in the blanket that I was holding and felt for a brachial pulse, which is on infants in the inner arm.
But you said he was breathing.
Yes, infants have a different, he was effectively breathing, but I wanted to make sure that what his heart rate was, because under 60 beats per minute indicates CPR needs to be initiated.
How did you first become aware that the baby was alive?
Officer Vitali, I believe is his name. He had stated, I believe the term was, it's here, it's moving, or something of that term, but I was notified by the officer.
Was the baby moving when you picked him up?
Slightly, yes.
Where'd you take the baby after you picked him up?
I had radioed to have an ambulance meet me back at the trestle bridge, so I left the woods with the baby in hopes to meet the ambulance at the trestle bridge.
Okay, can you just stand up one more time for me?
Sure.
Draw an arrow from where you recovered the baby to where you got back to the...
So there was a trail that led from the encampment and then back out to the paved rail trail down across the trestle bridge back to location one, which is where engine six was parked at the time.
Okay. When you took the baby, were you running, walking, something else?
Swiftly moving. I had thoughts of trying to remain steady on my feet, being it was icy, so I'd say I was just like jog.
Okay, and it looks like you made it back to the initial meeting point.
Correct.
About how long did that take you to get there?
Moments, under 5 minutes.
Okay. What were you doing while you were taking the baby back?
Vigorously rubbing and trying to warm the infant, as well as performing CPR.
So the defendant led you around for over an hour?
Yes.
And you were under 5 minutes from the baby?
Yes.
When you first met her?
Those times are marked by radio traffic, but yes.
So when you got out to the initial meeting point, what did you do then?
I had paused for a moment looking for the ambulance that I had requested. At that point, I had made a decision to transport in the back of a Manchester Fire Engine 6 instead of delaying patient care. We transported the baby to...
What do you mean instead of delaying patient care?
I didn't have any time limit on when the ambulance would arrive at my location where I was standing with the baby at the trestle bridge, location number one.
Where was the ambulance?
Staged behind Electric Street at position two.
So you arrive back at the initial meeting point, and there's no ambulance there?
No, sir.
But there was another vehicle there?
ALS Engine 6, Manchester Fire Engine 6.
Okay, and so so you couldn't wait for the ambulance to just come out from the parking lot?
The paramedic, Jason Trado, that was in the ambulance wasn't answering the radio, so I had no indication that he was aware that he was needed.
Well, you'd waited an hour and 10 minutes, so...
Yeah.
Did you wait longer?
No, sir. It's my job to make sure the patient gets to a higher level of care in a timely fashion, and standing there waiting for an ambulance didn't seem wise.
Okay. So you got into the, what is it, fire truck?
Yes, sir. It's an engine fire truck. Yes.
Okay. And where did you go from there?
We transported the baby to Catholic Medical Center.
Right. And what was the baby doing while you were transporting him to Catholic Medical Center?
Initially, we were all trying to actively warm in the back of the ambulance. Just as we were about to come down the hill by Station 6, so almost at arrival of the hospital, the baby opened.
Okay, you said in the back of the ambulance.
But I'm sorry, engine. I apologize. I'm used to transporting in an ambulance, so that's common terminology. In the back of the engine, there's a hill right before you get to CMC. At that point, you've noticed that the baby started moving his hands and he opened his eyes.
What happened when you got to the hospital?
I met with ER staff and passed off the baby.
No further questions. Thank you. You can have it.
Yeah, you just have to stay in front of the microphone.
Yeah, that was going to be this one. Is that okay? Hi, Ms. Berry.
Hello.
I know we met out in the lobby, but my name's Kim Kosick. And I'm just going to ask you a few questions. I represent Allie Eckersley.
Sure.
So when you... when you answer a call for AMR, do you work at AMR still?
I no longer work at that company, no.
So when you did work at AMR and you answer a call, there's a report generated.
Correct.
Is that correct? And in this case, you generated a report. Am I correct about that?
Yes.
That you signed?
The company generates the report. I just fill in certain parts of it, but yes.
Okay. You signed it?
Yes, ma'am.
Right? Okay. I'm just going to show you this. It's Bates stamp. I think it's just the AMR report. I'm going to show you this, and you can tell me if this is, if you recognize it. Do you recognize that? You don't have to worry about what's highlighted, but
yes.
You recognize it as your report? Or
yes.
A report?
Yes.
Okay. Have you looked at this since that day?
I have, yes.
Okay. When's the last time you looked at it?
Yesterday? Yes.
Who did you look at it with?
Myself.
Okay. So there are some times on here. You see where it says times?
Yes.
Okay. So this says that you were at the scene at 24:41.
Yes.
Do you disagree with that?
No, I was waiting.
Okay.
Wasn't sure if you were done asking a good question.
So you're at the scene at 24:41.
Yes.
Right?
Military time for
12:41.
Correct.
Okay. And then you're at the patient's side at 1:40.
Correct.
Do you agree with that?
Correct.
Okay. So that's less than an hour. Right?
If I did quick math, sure. I don't.
You want to take a look at it and tell me?
Correct.
Okay. So for the time you arrived at the scene,
mm-hmm.
That's when you pull in and stop. How's that time clocked?
So typically it would be through what they call an MDT. You'd push a button, so it would mark your on-scene time, if that makes sense.
You push a button like on a computer?
It communicates with fire alarm or dispatch.
Okay, all right. So you push a button to tell them when you've got there, and do you push a button, how does a transport time get put in there?
When you leave a location, it would indicate the same thing. It's a different button, but it would be some people call over the radio and say transporting, some people push the button.
Okay. And at patient side, I'm assuming it says at PT side, but that means at patient side?
Correct.
Okay. And how does that time get in there?
That's a manually input. So you would give a rough estimate of how long it took you to get from your initial on-scene time to finding the patient.
Okay. So did you put that time in or someone else put it in?
I did not, ma'am. AMR did.
Okay, how do they know what time it is?
I would have to ask them, but typically in a regular situation, the times are recorded at the dispatch center of Manchester Fire Alarm.
Okay.
And then that report communicates to AMR.
Right, so just to make sure I'm clear. So when you are, is it when you leave, you were in the ambulance, right? At that point when you left, you were in the fire truck?
Correct.
You left the scene?
Yes.
With the baby? Yeah. Okay. So, just looking at this report, is there more than one report, or is this the only report?
To the best of my knowledge, I believe there's another one, but I've never witnessed it because I'm not on that report.
Okay. Do you know where that report is?
I don't. I no longer work for that company.
Okay. Do you know who would have signed that report?
I would assume, just based off assumptions, it would be the paramedic, Natalia Risha, that was on the scene.
So she should have her own report?
Correct.
Is that right?
That's the normal way of doing it. I don't know if that's how it worked out.
Okay. So this report, it says, so the nature of the call is first trimester serious bleeding. Is that right?
That's nature of the call is placed in there. How it was dispatched was worded differently, but yes.
Okay. And, but the patient name is blacked out. So do you know the patient's name?
Are you still holding my report, ma'am?
I can show it to you. Yeah. It's redacted for me.
So this is for, at that time, the identifier for the patient was baby.
Okay, so baby Eckersley.
Correct.
All right. And do you know what his actual name is?
I've heard what his actual name is. Edward Luth.
Objection. May we approach?
Yes. The other microphone, so I don't.
Sure. Anyway, thank you.
No, we're not going to take that microphone.
Okay.
Leaning all over it. Sorry. Okay, so this baby was a little boy, right? Do you know that?
I found out after I had cleared the CMC, but yes, I do know that.
Okay. And did you know that from looking at your own report, the AMR report?
No, because at the time of writing that, I don't remember if I'm not sure. Honestly, I don't recall.
Do you want to look at it?
Sure. If I referred to it, I believe that I know the moment I was told.
That's
so
fine.
I refer to him as an infant.
Okay, I just would ask you to look at the top of the report. See, on the top, I think, right-hand corner.
Oh, I'm sorry, yes, sex says male.
Okay, so, but you didn't put that in, someone else did?
It's a click button in that program,
right.
So I would assume I did it.
This is the same program that you're talking about? You pushed the button to say what time we got there?
That's a MDT system. This is a patient care reporting system. It's a computer program versus the MDT is also a computer, but it communicates with dispatch. Two different programs, but yes.
Okay, so you punched that in?
Believed to be, yes.
At some point.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
You gave Allie Eckersley, who's this baby's mother, right?
Yes.
Yes? You gave her some medical treatment, correct?
Correct.
Some emergency treatment.
Correct.
Right? And she didn't refuse you looking at her or checking her out, correct?
Correct.
Okay. What she refused was going to the hospital.
Correct.
Right? She didn't want to go to the hospital?
Correct.
She was scared to go to the hospital?
Correct.
Okay. She said it gave her PTSD.
I don't remember that. I know that she was mentioning something of that nature, but I don't remember the exact wording of what she stated, but yes.
Okay. She was uncomfortable going to the hospital.
Yes.
Okay. So, and like you said, you can't kidnap her or make her go, so she didn't go, but you continued to provide medical care throughout this hour or so that you were together.
Yes.
Is that correct? When you were in the ambulance?
I would say more supportive care. I didn't really do any interventions to her, which would be invasive medical procedures. I didn't, after she refused care, was more of like noticing that she was bleeding again, so I wanted to recheck her blood pressure.
Okay, well you did, you checked her blood pressure.
Correct.
When you first got her into the ambulance, let me back up a little bit. So you everyone goes to the scene, the fire goes and you go, AMR goes, right?
Mm-hmm.
Get there around the same time?
Roughly, yes.
Yeah, truck 6 was there first, and then you were there.
Correct.
Okay. So when you get there, does someone say, hey, the patient's over here at the end of this path, or do you get out and see her?
Lieutenant Poulin, I pulled up alongside truck 6. Lieutenant Poulin was standing up my window at the point of positioning of the ambulance. He stated, I have a patient that says she gave birth to two babies in the woods at that point. I notified my partner to call a second ALS, and I exited the ambulance and began getting supplies in the back and of my ambulance. We have OB kits, pregnancy kits, pre-made. I got one of those and a few other things and extricated the stretcher out of the ambulance and went over to her side where she had two other advanced EMTs from Manchester Fire at her side.
Okay. Do you know if either of them wrote a report?
I do know that Manchester Fire staff did. I don't know the exact personnel that wrote the reports.
Okay. So when you take out this OB kit and you're going to put Allie back in the ambulance, right, on the stretcher,
mm-hmm.
You didn't treat her outside?
No.
Statement.
No, it was cold out. I tried to get her in the ambulance as
right,
best
it was cold
could.
Out.
Yes.
Yeah. So you put her back in the ambulance, and what do you do with the – did you use the OB kit? What do you do with it?
No, I didn't need to. I used what they call trauma pads.
What's that?
It's a thick medical padding, almost like a feminine pad, but bigger and square to absorb blood.
Okay, so when you say you used that, did you like gave it to her to put in her pants?
She had had a blanket that she was utilizing as that similar idea when I encountered her. So we just tried to help her with massaging and getting initial vitals and...
Okay, so you took the blanket. Did she take the blanket out of her pants, or you did that?
I don't remember. I believe it was her. I might have assisted. I don't remember that part.
All right, so did she get up off the stretcher and take her own pants off and take the blanket out?
She never took her pants never came off. They were stretchy,
mm-hmm.
So you could stretch them with them being on her body.
Okay, so you testified that you checked her out, and she did not have a cord still in her.
Correct.
How did you do that?
You could pull the pants and there would be a cord visible, but...
Okay, so you didn't see one?
No.
Right? Did you do an internal exam?
That's not my protocols. I'm not allowed to do such things.
Okay, so you wouldn't have known if it was still something in there or not, right?
Correct.
Okay, but we know that there was a placenta on the side of the trail.
I later found out, yes.
Correct? Okay.
Yes.
So you found out, did you see it?
I walked by it, yes.
All right. Did someone alert you to it?
The officer in the video found it first, and then we walked by as a group. I looked down, noticed it, and then I proceeded to the location of the baby.
Where the baby is, okay. So when you hear Officer Collins saying, you know, turns around and says, is this a placenta? And then he says he wants to ask someone, I guess, that knows more than he does, or however he put it. That's you?
Me and the paramedic that was with me. There was also another advanced EMT on scene.
Okay. Was that person Ms. Risher?
Natalia Risher, yes.
Okay. So how long, I know you said, I think you said you don't know, but if you don't know, tell me. How long was she in the ambulance? So you get her into the ambulance, sort of getting her cleaned up a little bit?
Yeah, I don't have an exact time on that, other than a few moments. I would stay more than 5, but less than 15, I'd assume.
Okay. The first time she was inside?
Correct.
All right. And that's when you were trying to clean her up or help her out?
I was trying multiple things, trying to assess her, help her, trying to figure out more things. I was asking, like, when her last menstrual cycle. Sorry, my mouth is so dry.
It's okay. There's water right there.
Yeah, I just don't want to be rude.
No, it's not rude. Believe me, I drink all the whole pitcher of water.
Be careful with
the
lid,
yeah. I had asked questions. Trying to gauge, typically when you have a female that's had a miscarriage, you want to know when their last menstrual cycle was to know how far along they were, how big of a delivery the baby, mm-hmm. whether was I looking for a essentially unidentifiable tissue matter, was it going to be a fetal demise, was it going to be a baby, so I was asking stuff like that, while also asking questions about the gentleman that was there, while also asking medical questions.
Okay, let me ask you just a since you brought it up, the gentleman that was there. So did you see that person yourself?
As I pulled up, he walked across from where she was seated across the front of my ambulance and headed southeast on the rail trail. So yes.
Walking, running?
Walked.
Okay. Did you hear him say anything?
No.
All right. And I think you said you thought it was weird or odd that he was just leaving her there.
It's abnormal for someone to be in a medical incident like that and have their support system walk away and not stay with them or help out or answer questions. So yeah, I felt it was odd.
Okay. You knew it was her support system? How?
She had called him her boyfriend.
Okay.
So to me, my boyfriend would never leave me in that situation. So it was odd to me.
Good thing. Yeah. Okay. So you assumed he was her support system?
Yes.
Okay. And so you, you're in the ambulance, the police get there, right? The police arrive at some point.
Yes.
Like you said, she was in there the first time, like between 5 and 15 minutes. So
yeah.
The police get there between 5 and 15 minutes later.
Sure. I don't have an exact time, but yes. When we repositioned and to staging location 2 was when my first encounter, I don't know if they were there prior to me exiting the ambulance, but my first encounter of PD was exiting the ambulance.
Okay, there. I'm sorry. I didn't know if they were there before that.
I wouldn't be. They might have been. I just didn't see them because I was in the back of the ambulance with her.
Got it. So you didn't hear that? They didn't come with the sirens? You didn't hear that?
No, the overnights, they tend to not run sirens unless they actually have to. So.
Okay. So when they came, did Allie volunteer to go with them to, like, help look for the baby, or no?
She had, the first time at this point, yeah. She was declining to go to the hospital. Mm-hmm. So at that point, I asked her if she'd be willing to help us locate the baby, being that she'd be the best source of description to go find it. She was her firsthand experience.
Okay. So you guys got her out of the ambulance?
Yes. She assisted. We assisted her, but she got herself out of the ambulance.
Yeah, speaking sort of colloquially, like she got out of the ambulance.
I just have to be very definite in those medically, but yes, she was able to get herself out of the ambulance
you
with our,
very
no.
Okay. And then you told her that if she felt any gushing, to tell you.
Yes, right? I still had concerns for her, but I had to honor her wishes of not wanting to go to the hospital.
I understand, but I'm just saying that you said that to her.
Yes.
Correct, because she was still bleeding. Is that right or not bleeding?
She was slightly, not life-threatening, but gushing to me would be hemorrhaging. So I wanted her to update us if that was to occur.
Okay. So the bleeding had stopped or slowed, or which is it?
I would say slowed enough to a point of not really recognizing that she was still bleeding because she was in such saturated clothing, but it wasn't gushing or it wasn't spreading on the stretcher. I couldn't state it stopped and entirely because, again, I didn't do an internal exam.
Okay. So you said her clothes were saturated.
Prior to my arrival, yes.
Yeah, despite her blanket that was in her pants, that was also saturated?
Yes. I went not in the entirety, but yes.
Okay. Did you have any clothes in the, do you carry that kind of thing in the ambulance, like clothes for people that are?
No, ma'am.
In peril?
No, we don't. Okay. The ERs typically do. We don't have patients long enough to do that stuff.
Yeah.
We provide her with a blanket.
Okay. So what is, if you know, I don't know how much training you have in OBGYN matters, but is it normal for bleeding postpartum to dry up after an hour of after giving birth?
I don't feel that would be something I should comment on medically, because as you said, I'm not trained in OB, but there are different reasons why you could bleed during childbirth. It'd not necessarily be a life-threatening hemorrhage. But again, I mean, bleeding clots in its own time in every human, so I don't think anybody could reasonably give an answer to that. Every person's different.
Okay. And you were with, were you with Officer Hennessy? Were you the person that was walking with him? I apologize because I
don't know who that, I know their faces.
Were you walking with an officer?
There was a lot of us walking at the same time.
So at the time that you guys got out of the ambulance, Allie got us out of the ambulance and you get out of the ambulance and you're going to go look for the baby, were you and Natalia Risher both walking with the police, or was it just you?
Nope, both of us, as well as AMT Justin Kaufman from AMR.
Are you the person that said, that told Allie, or officer, I'm going to say Officer Hennessy, but told a police officer.
Okay.
That Allie had called 911 herself? Did you say that?
I don't recall.
Okay. Did you say, did you gesture about how big the baby was? Do you remember having that conversation?
I don't recall it.
But Allie had said that he cried.
She had told me at one point, initially she told me in the back of the ambulance on the first encounter that she had had a menstruation 1 month prior. So to me that indicated that there was going to be a non-viable if not fetal demise. So we were searching for if not tissue matter. And then when she had slipped up throughout the interactions, she had stated that it had cried for a minute. So to me that had indicated that it was a baby that was farther along than I originally anticipated.
That was when you were still in the
At some point, I don't remember the exact moment. I believe we were in an ambulance when she stated that. But it was a thing in my head that I was like, wait, what? You told me that you had just had a menstruation 30 days prior, so.
Mm-hmm. Did she tell you that?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, okay. Do you remember telling a police officer that?
I don't.
Did you tell anyone else that she had said that?
My partner, the paramedic that I was working with.
Okay. And do you know if she told anyone else that?
I don't. We weren't with each other every moment of the call.
Okay, so the two of you, at the early on, both knew that Allie gets the baby and had cried for some.
I wouldn't say early on, no. She had stated that well into the call, that the baby had cried for a moment.
Well into?
Well into our searching.
When did she say that?
I don't have exact time frame, but it was after we had made it to the second location. I had been searching for a while. It wasn't in the initial interactions in the back of the ambulance.
When did you tell Natalia Risher?
At some point while we were talking about the patient.
Call the Hennessy one.
Counsel, you need to use your mic.
Sorry, Judge, thank you.
Counsel, you all need to use your mute buttons. Otherwise, everything you say is being picked up.
If I showed you a portion of body cam from when you were out walking around with Allie and the police, would that refresh your recollection?
Sure. Sure, if it's me, I'm sorry.
Right, that's what I also want you to tell me.
Sure.
If it's you. I start to play it. I just want to make sure. Is this you?
I believe so.
It's very
yes.
blurry.
I believe it's me.
Okay. So that's you inside the ambulance?
Yes.
Correct?
Sorry, I was trying to see.
I'm going to play without sound so you can tell me if you recognize where you are.
Can I just tilt this down
sure,
just a little bit? Sorry.
You want to come up and look? Yeah. So I'm going to run it back a little bit so you can tell me if you recognize where you are.
Yep.
You recognize that?
Yes.
Okay. So that's a path you walked.
That was the initial path she took to when she exited the ambulance out.
Okay.
Yep.
And you and Ms. Risher are both on this walk?
Correct.
Okay. So if I'm going to play it, do I need to mute anything? If I'm going to play
I'll
very lightly?
Okay. This is just a refresher collection.
Correct.
Okay.
in, and I would expect that we will end by 4 o'clock today. All right? All rise for the jurors. You can just stay put right there.
Okay.